What's the best platform for hosting your UX or UI design portfolio? In this video, CareerFoundry mentor Kim Steindel shares his favorite platforms to build your UX and UI design portfolio on. He details pros and cons of each so you can make the most informed decision. Now let's dive in and find out which platform might suit your needs best.
One of the most asked questions that I get all the time, what platform should I use? There is a lot of different platforms out there. I don't know how many hundreds or thousands. Basically, everything can be a platform. So I chose a few to give you an idea what they can be used for, how they are useful, and what you can do with it. So the first category is free and easy. Any specific technical knowledge, they are very easy to operate and they are free. So if we are looking for a new job and we don't have like $200-300 we could spend on this, then this is a great choice. My personal favorites are Weebly and Wix. They are website building tools. It's the same like Squarespace. Squarespace is probably what most of you know. Why Weebly and Wix? Because they have great free website building plans that don't require any programming. So if you go with a free website with them, you don't have a site limit, or you don't have like content limit. You don't have an upload limit for a lot of things. You can still implement HD features. The only difference between a paid and an unpaid account for these websites is that you can't use your own domain name. So for example, if you have www.firstname.lastname.com, that's not possible. It would be www.firstname.lastname.weebly.com instead. For recruiters, that doesn't really matter. And since it's a document where you upload this anyway, you can just use a quick link. You can just rename it to My Portfolio, and when they click it, they're on it. But for recruiters, it's not important that you paid for it. It's more of your personal branding, and it might be more important if you're going the freelance route. But if you're looking for a job in this area, then this is perfect. The next ones are Behance, Instagram, and Dribbble. I have a differentiation here between different portfolio things. A lot of students that I'm talking with have existing design experience, but maybe not UI and UX experience. Maybe they come from an architecture background. Maybe they come from a fashion design background, maybe graphic design, maybe 3D design, maybe modeling, maybe fine arts, maybe photography, right? So there is a lot of skills that are cross-transferable and a lot of things that could be great, but it's really difficult to advertise this. And the best ways to advertise these kind of skills and your pre-existing knowledge is for Behance, Instagram, and Dribbble. You don't need to upload like these huge case studies as you would with your portfolio. You could just have it more as a social account where you feature stuff that you're passionate about. One thing you will find if you research different designers in different companies, you will find that they have a Behance account or a Dribbble account and a website. And usually on their Behance account, they have like small things, graphic design work, photographies. I had someone lately who tailored dresses themselves, so they featured that. And usually that is very well received by recruiters, even if it's not completely job relevant, because depending on the country, usually social media websites are blocked. But by nature, recruiters are very interested in social media. So by giving them the chance of checking this for a business-related reason, it goes a little bit into psychology, it really makes us happy to look at this. And if it's something we find interesting, then we may give you the interview without even looking at your case study. We are also human after all. And if we were bored for like 2 or 3 hours, and now we look at something that we really like, even if it's not directly related, you are still in our good books. So if you check the other boxes, your chance of an interview just increased. The last thing is I found not as much known, but you can use Google Docs for very targeted or spontaneous applications as well as freelance work. One of the problems that a lot of students raise to me is that once you have a case study online, it's really difficult to change that. It's really difficult to make it targeted or to make it really specific. For example, maybe you have done a huge case study that is focused on the research, but now your dream job and it's everything you see is just very design and stylized. guided, right? So there's not much use for your other case study. So changing this all around is not really feasible if you want to apply for a job. So for this, you can use Google Docs. It's a specific link. You can make it look really good, and you can just send it to people directly. So it's a case study for these people only. It will not be on the internet. It will not have an impact on other things. But especially when you're looking for freelance work and you're solving specific problems, this works like a charm. It is what I am personally using, almost exclusively to land my freelance work, because I can just put in what I know about the company and how to help them. It goes back to the research, right? Currently, I'm working a lot with e-commerce companies, so I know a lot of them are struggling with visibility, with the checkout process, or with the conversion rates. So I can just create a case study for these three pain points and just send it and make it very personal. So these are free options. Of course, there are loads more, but these are some that I would recommend. Next one, paid options. God, there are tens of thousands of different choices. It would probably take me a year to cover all of them, so I'll just go into the ones that I like. The first one, WordPress and WordPress templates or website builders. Same as Weebly and Wix, but just with paid plans. The cost, yeah, it can be as cheap as three bucks a month. That was the cheapest I found for linking your domain name. And it can be a lot more than that. But typically, most of them are around 20 bucks a month. And then depending on yearly plans or monthly plans, that's what you should probably expect with these. Typically, these websites have more options to really help you with your vision and what you're interested in. If you like, let's say you like Squarespace. Squarespace is pretty expensive. Squarespace is, I think, 20 bucks for the starter plan for your website. So compared to other options, that's not cheap, but it has a lot of really beautiful templates. And if you see something that you really like and you feel you could bring your vision really to life with it, that's probably what you're looking at. Some of these, especially with WordPress, require a little bit of programming language. So be aware of that. We also have specialized portfolio tools. So rather than website tools, these are tools that are more often used for portfolios. And the two ones that I found most useful on this is UXfolio and Webflow. They are fairly cheap for what they offer. I think it was $15 plus, and I think UXfolio even has a free plan for, one or two projects, I think. So you can get started for free and then expand on it. But for both of these, a little bit of programming language is useful. They are great tools. The websites that I've seen of this are awesome, but they require a little bit more work. Now, we have alternative options. I think the most difficult part of landing a job in this space or in the tech industry in general is standing out from the crowd. Yes, UX and UI design is growing like crazy and there is tons of jobs available, but that also means there is tons of competition, especially since these jobs are not as established in some countries. It means that there is not a lot of official clarification of what a good applicant should be like. So you will have a lot of cases where you get applications that are not really good. So it's like a sea of really bad applications with the occasional good one or excellent one in it. So you have a way of standing out through that by not going the traditional portfolio case. Do this with caution, because you're always on the safe side with a portfolio, and a great portfolio will always perform well. But if you feel you want to do something else, or if you just want to try something, then these are some of the things you could do. The first thing is a YouTube portfolio. So instead of having a web presence as a website, you could do a video of your high fidelity prototype and you could present it. You could click through all the things. It makes it way more real. Video as a medium is way more accepted than written parts in terms of holding your attention. It's way more likely that someone sits through a video than someone who reads your whole case study. So you can absolutely use YouTube to make like one or two case studies you're passionate about, and then you can send it to people. And since you can unlist them, no one else will find these videos, and only those people with the link will do. The next thing that is interesting that I saw work well for some students is that the design tools like Sketch, Figma, and Adobe, they have creative solutions to do a portfolio. So you could create a resume app, or you could create a hiring journey map, or basically anything else that you would want to do with it. I've seen people do like a full portfolio case study with the resume and cover letter attached in it, in more of a click-through playful kind of way, right? So if you have a great idea about this and you feel you want to try this, go ahead. You will at least have some eyes on it. This is also an alternative option, is third-party networking. What I mean by that is you often have the option to work for a company for free that is maybe in your area. For example, a good success rate is for NGOs. There is a ton of NGOs. A lot of them struggle and don't really have money, and a lot of them have really outdated websites because the NGO was started as a passion project from like one or two people, and maybe they don't have the resources or the time to create something that is better than the bare minimum. But what these companies have, or even startups or other companies, is they are usually connected to different companies as well. So if you struggle finding an interview and you're struggling the conventional way, try to land like one or two free projects that you find really good, and then communicate to the owner that you would love it if they could introduce you to someone else, or that they could recommend you to other clients if they hear that something is open. I had a student recently who landed a full-time position this way because they helped an animal shelter NGO by basically overhauling their website. And these guys went to like a job fair, but it was more like a donation fair kind of thing. And of course, the different NGOs are talking to each other. So one of them was mentioning, hey, your website looks really good. Who did that? Right? And that's how she got a full-time job out of it. The last thing is build it yourself. One of the entry requirements for a lot of jobs is that they want commercial experience. You can see this very often in gaming related companies. They always ask for a list of games that you worked on, or websites that you programmed, or tools that you created. So if you don't want to have something that is just theoretical, then a good way is just to build it yourself, right? Build a small app. Try to translate your knowledge in there. Build your own website for it, right? There are free options for this. It just is about, does it look good or not? So yeah, this is especially useful for gaming companies. The easiest way to start in a gaming company is to program a small game or to design gaming interfaces.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope the webinar snippet was very valuable for you. Let us know in the comments what your favorite portfolio platform is and why. If you want to see more design events like this, check out our events page on careerfoundry.com. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for more weekly videos like this. Thank you so much for watching, and see you next time.